The ESP32 line of electronic products has become a mainstream platform for makers and industrial applications. But in the last few years, Espressif have been releasing a ton of different application-specific ESP32 SoCs. So much so that it has become super confusing to choose the right Espressif SoC for your application. In this episode of 5-Minute Tech Take, we solve this confusion once and for all. Let's start with the ESP32 H2. ESP32 H2 is the first ESP32 chip that started to embrace other wireless protocols. On top of Wi-Fi and BLE, it adds Thread and ZigBee protocols. Furthermore, the combined availability of ZigBee and BLE enables built-in devices for the Matter protocol, which intends to bring interoperability for smart home devices across different ecosystems. Also, this SoC comes with an integrated DC-DC converter that enables ultra-low power energy efficient operations. Thus, ESP32 H2 is best suited for the following applications: smart connected devices from different ecosystems, Thread border routers, ZigBee gateways, Matter border routers, ultra-low power industrial applications. Now let's talk about the two SoCs in the ESP32 C series, namely ESP32 C6 and C3. ESP32 C3 is a single-core Wi-Fi and BLE5 SoC based on the open-source 32-bit core RISC-V architecture. This is the first RISC-based SoC from Espressif, and the key aim was to be a replacement for ESP8266. It is multiple times more secure than ESP8266, it supports BLE5 with long-range mode support, it consumes very less power, larger memory and more stable support with ESP-IDF than ESP8266. Espressif claims it's super easy to migrate from ESP8266 to ESP32 C3. So now the potential applications are: upgrade existing ESP8266 lineup of products you already sell. Consider this over ESP8266 if you are building smart home or smart office products. Now let's look at the ESP32 C6. It's just an ESP32 C3 on steroids. Well, on steroids in terms of connectivity, I mean. The ESP32 C3 has Wi-Fi 4, while the ESP32 C6 replaces that with Wi-Fi 6 capabilities while maintaining backward compatibility. It's already certified by Wi-Fi Alliance out of the box. This is one less thing to worry about for a developer. Wi-Fi 6 is faster, low power, secure, reliable, and more devices can be connected at the same time, which is essential for IoT. So now the potential applications are: creating future-proof smart devices, industrial applications where a lot of devices are involved. Finally, let's look at the two ESP32 SoCs in the S series. The ESP32 S series is like a direct upgrade to the mainstream ESP32 lineup. The upgrades include faster processor architecture, more security, and on-chip AI capabilities. Let's look at ESP32 S2 SoC first. The ESP32 S2 is a low-power, single-core Wi-Fi SoC designed to be secure and cost-effective with a high performance and a rich set of I/O capabilities. The ESP32 S2 comes with a more powerful RISC-V-based ULP coprocessor along with newer single main processor. The lack of a dual-core processor is somehow balanced by the faster single-core LX7 architecture core. ESP32 S2 is also capable of dynamically turning off the Wi-Fi when not in use to save power. These two features make it highly energy efficient. It also provides a lot of new hardware-based security features. So where can ESP32 S2 be used? If your application does not need the power of dual cores to, say, do free RTOS but would benefit a lot from the cool security and power features of S2, you can replace the ESP32 with an ESP32 S2. So in a way, just like how ESP32 C3 is a replacement for ESP8266, ESP32 S2 aims to be a replacement for ESP32. Now let's finish off by discussing the ESP32 S3. ESP32 S3 is specifically aimed at AIoT products. It's an upgraded ESP32 S2 with a dual-core Extensa 32-bit LX7 architecture processor clocked at 240 MHz and features AI vector instructions as well as reliable security encryption engine. Developers can take advantage of these AI vector instructions through ESP-DSP and ESP-NN libraries to optimize their applications. ESP Who and ESP Skynet SDKs will also support this acceleration. Use cases include offline voice recognition applications, computer vision applications, wake word detection applications, multi-dimensional human-machine interfaces. We have come to the end of the video, and you can like and share the video if you found it useful. Also, don't forget to subscribe to Chip in Detail for more such videos.